Before commencing the day's proceedings, I would like to brief you on certain procedures to be followed in case of any emergency. We are glad to inform you that the facility is equipped with adequate safety systems to take care of any untoward incident. We have trained emergency response teams who will act as first responders in case of any eventuality. A team of fire brigade, a section of military and civil police each are deployed in the campus and parking areas to take care of safety and security of all guests. On occurrence of any untoward incident in this hall, please do not panic. Trained volunteers will help you exit from this hall. There are three emergency exits in this hall. One on my left and two exits on both sides of the hall sides and back. You will notice our emergency response team members seated near each of these exits and on the balcony wearing an ERT cap. They will guide you to a safe exit from the hall. Please facilitate movement of senior citizens, specially able persons, pregnant women and children. In case of a major emergency, the designated safe assembly area is top class, and we request you all to assemble at the top class and await further instructions. I request the shutters of the balcony to be closed as it disturbs the artists. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are delighted and honored to have Mrs. Enos as our chief guest for this evening's school play. Mrs. Enos is an institution who has shaped the future of countless Lawrencians and continues to inspire us with all her spirit and work that is endless.
Mrs. Enos, my privilege to have you here this evening. Lovely having you here. This year's senior school play requires a little bit of talk from my side. I think we are breaking new grounds with this play. My apologies to those who were here for the dress rehearsal. I will try not to repeat what I said on the 20th. But if I do, I'm an old bird with the same call. I'd like to read a poem first by a Russian poet, Yevgeny Yevtushenko. And it's called Lies. Lying to the young is wrong. Proving to them that lies are true is wrong. Telling them that God's in his heaven and all's well with the world is wrong. They know what you mean. They are people too. Tell them the difficulties can't be counted. And let them see not only what will be, but see with clarity these present times. Say obstacles exist, they must encounter. Sorrow comes, hardship happens, the hell with it. Who never knew the price of happiness will not be happy, but forgive no error you recognize. It will repeat itself 100-fold, and afterwards our pupils will not forgive in us what we forget. On the onset, please let me tell you that I would like to clarify that contrary to what generally people believe or take for granted, I am not a theatre person. It's a brand that has been given. I work with children and young people, and then theatre and drama becomes my methodology. And when I work with them, I strive to take their minds for a walk. In India, I fall under no socially acceptable or recognized profession, and I am generally treated with the same semi-disguised dismissal, condescending behavior, fake and sterile communication, and a psychoanalytical approach that most young people experience. They get it every day. And so like them, I have no identity or individuality. It then becomes a constant struggle to survive and have one's voice heard. The resilience required to endure this non-stop onslaught, this emotional abuse, is extremely exhausting. And many, many of us, many of our young people then wither away or live their lives screaming silently with false smiles attached to their faces, living a life of pretense. If you really want to see the color of a child, you need to go into the forest. Try bird watching. You have to be quiet. You have to listen. You need to sense them. And the joy that you have when that bird flies, because that's where it exhibits its colors and the pattern. And your children are like that. Tread softly, let them fly. That's the only way you will see their colors. If you try and control them, they will fly, they will never come back. Don't complain. You cannot bring up your children today based on the parameters that were prevalent in your time, my time. You cannot play the power game. Use emotional blackmail as your tool of control. There has to be a difference between discipline and regimentation. Two different things altogether. So this evening's presentation will challenge the sensibilities of everybody here in many ways. But it should not be taken as a threat or the onslaught of disobedience. Each individual, each person sitting here will have their own interpretation and eventual justification. But either way, this play will stay in your mind for a long time and it will grow if you allow it to grow. You may have to rethink your and re-evaluate your relationship with the world of the young people as to how you want to nurture them. This play has been totally on a workshop process. There was no script. I would get these complaints, a lot of people, what is the play about, what is the play about? I didn't know myself. It has taken me 10 years to get this play to Lawrence Lovedale. And everything that you see on stage today is the creation of these 30 people who I'm proud to say in all my years of association with this school, collectively they are the best bunch of kids I have ever had.
They have gone through hell with me. So, for example, if you don't look at what, this was a response from one of the students on the press rehearsal day,
that so many things are happening, we don't know what to do. So at a given point, the play has no dialogue. None. So at a given point, there may be about 150 things happening on stage, all created by these 30 people. Every day we have sat down, talked about the play, discussed, written something, trashed it. It has been a very democratic process. They have walked all over me. But we have come to something where the first track is when they come together with the masks that they are given or they are born with or whatever. It's been. They tell you, here we are. And There are millions of millions like us. The second is probably one of the toughest. I had the children breaking down every second day, crying to an extent that some of them were unable to breathe. And the process that was given to them for this particular, I gave them a piece of paper and I asked them to write their life stories from as long as they can remember till the present time. Then select three most important sentences in that piece of paper, and then out of those three sentences, the three most important words, which was the core of their life story, and then they had to present it on stage by giving a sound and a movement. That is it. Out of the 30 sounds, nearly 28 are cries of pain. An absolute anguish. It would be disastrous if the adult world, including parents, they are petrified. They are petrified. I had to first exhibit my life story to them before I asked for their life story. And what they have written will die with me. It has not been shared. So again, when you're working with young people or anyone, trust is probably one of the most important aspects of education. They need to trust you. Don't threaten them. Yes, ma'am, they'll get back. The third is threats. If you see the performance chronology, third is threats. It's symbolic of the threats that they get every day. Then there is an awakening. Within them there is an awakening. What do we do? Then there is a sense of freedom. They do come together. At the end, the last track, that's when they connect with you directly. They are beseeching you. Walk with them. They are pleading. They're fine, we will take a step. Would you take half a step? Fine. We will smile as bright as possible. Could you give a pinch of smile for us? Where are you lost? You consider us lost? Where are you lost? If we are both lost, let's get up. Let's walk. What they are, and we were discussing it till this morning, they are still petrified of being reprimanded by the parents. How could you do this on stage? They don't want to be analyzed. They are afraid of being ridiculed, questioned as to why the bloody hell did you show this on stage. It's their voices. It's the story of their lives. You need to listen. You need to be sensitive. I'll end with something that came from the young people. And it's the truth. The pain that I feel so deep inside, the hurt, the shame, and all the lies, people that I lived with thought they would be the people that I love. With the hate, the anger, the yelling, the teasing, and the madness. The more that I cry, the more I think there is no love. When I go to school, they always talk about me. When I come home to the place where I sleep, that's not where I want to be. Sometimes I feel I don't want to be in this world. If someone shot me, I wonder how they would feel. Happy? Mad? Or pretend that they are sad? The pain that I feel so deep inside, the hurt, the shame, and all the lies, and then I have added these are not mine. And so I play my world of make-believe. I play it every day, but people stand and watch me, but don't know what to say. They give me diagnostic tests. They try out reading schemes, but none of them will ever know the color of my dreams. So ladies and gentlemen, I give you 30 people, Neev Se Udaan Tak, or From the Foundation to the Flight, a journey of transition.
There comes a time when you stand at the crossroads, thinking whether to turn left or right. Will you choose the path that's difficult or the easy one? Will it bring you glory and fortune or pain and shame? You only have a moment to decide, and a lifetime to feel proud or repent. You turn left when everybody is turning right. You dare, just like some of us do.
Stop. Life is a beautiful journey, but ultimately